Hello friends, welcome to our today's session on Spark. In this series, we are learning Spark interview question, and in our today's video, we will solve one of the interview question that is recently asked in Spark interviews. So the question is, consider we have a CSV file in a folder in a recursive manner. I had shown you a sample file here, a sample scenario here. Like we might have a root folder. Inside that root folder itself, we are having a CSV file. And also inside the root folder, we have some subfolders as well, which will have a CSV files as well. And then inside the subfolders as well, we are having a folder which contains a CSV file. So with this scenario, we need to load all these files at a time, and we need to display those as a Spark data frame. So that is our requirement here. We will be using PySpark as a programming language to solve this scenario. If you are looking for a same scenario to be solved in Spark with Scala, I will make a separate video and I will give it an I button as well as in the description of this video. You can go ahead and check out that. So that being said, let us move on to our today's demo. So I am into my Databricks Community Edition account. I have started the cluster as well as created the notebook for our demo purpose. Let me walk you through each and every step. I hope the screen is visible. Let me make it somewhat bigger. As a first step, let me check whether the cluster is up and properly running. Yes, I have already uploaded the files into my Databricks DBFS. So let me show you. I will go to the data here, and then here you can find something like DBFS. I'm selecting that. Inside that, I have uploaded the file under the path file store uploads. And here I have created a folder called FileDel Input. So inside this, you can see the CSV file which is under the root directory itself, and also some folders, data fold 1, data fold 2, data fold 3, which has some CSV files inside it, as you can see here. So also there were some subfolders as well inside the data fold, which also contains the CSV file. So this is our initial setup for the input file. Let me go back to the workspace that we have. So as a first step, I am giving a ls command to list all the files that is available under the root directory. So FileDel Input is our root directory. Here you can find we have one CSV file and other three are the data folders that we have. Let me also give a display command. Let me also read a file and give a display command to show you the data. There is not much data. We have 5 files, file 1, file 2, file 3, file 4 and file 5 in each of the recursive directories, and each file has a couple of records. So totally we have around 10 records. We are checking, like we are reading the CSV file and I am just giving the root directory alone, FileDel Input alone. And I am displaying the record. Let us see how many records are being displayed. And I am giving the header as true as well. So here you can check. Only couple of records are being displayed. So this couple of records, I think these are from root directories. We can check that from which directory it is being displayed in. So for that, we are using the function called input file name. I am importing the function from pyspark.sql.function. And then I am using it in the with column. I am adding a new column called file name, and I am using this input file name function, as you can see here, and I am displaying it so that it will display the file location. Let me run this. So the job got completed. If you check, we can see like the file1.csv is the file that is present under the root directory. So only the file under the root directory is being read and displayed. But we need all the files to be read and displayed at a time. So we need to do some logic. So let us see how we can read all the files. As a method 1, we can directly hard code all the path as a list and then read the file. So that is the first method. As you can see here, I am creating a list called i_path, and I am giving all the folders that is available. Like you can see, this is the root folder, and under root folder I am giving fold 1, fold 2, fold 3, and under fold 3 I have another subfolder called subfold 1. So I am providing all the path, and then this list I am using it in the data frame reader. you can see here like spark.read.format.csv, and then inside load I am giving in underscore path, which is nothing but our list, and then I am displaying the data frame. So let us do this and check how the data is being displayed, whether it is able to get all the records. So now you can find the difference, like it is showing all the 10 rows that is being as a part of the CSV file. So once again let us confirm it, like we can use the same function that we have used in the above command. Let me copy this. And let me paste it in our original command that we are working on. So after load I will paste it. Like after load we have a with column, file name and input file name. So let me run this now. Got completed. And you can see it has read all the files. Like inside data fold 1 I have a file 2. And we have a couple of records there, and inside data fold 2 I have a file 3, couple of records, data fold 3, couple of records, under data fold 3 again I have a couple of records. So in this way we are able to confirm it, like each and every file under the main folder has a CSV file, and those CSV file has been read using our command. So this is method 1. But there is a major disadvantage with this method is like you have to hard code all the path. This with the limited number of path it is possible and it is very easy for us. But if we don't know the number of files and the number of folders that is being available under the root directory, then it is very difficult for us to go through this approach. So we need to find some automated approach which will read through recursively all the folders and all the files available under the root directory. So for that we are having a method 2 which will have an option called recursive lookup file. We are going to enable that option and check whether we are able to read it. So here you can observe like the same command spark.read.format of CSV, and only thing I am changing is I am adding an option called recursive file lookup and I am enabling it as true. So I am giving a root folder directly here. I am not giving any list or anything. As you can see in under load, I am giving only the root directory, file del input, and I am displaying the data frame. So let me run this. So as you can see, we are getting all the records that is under the root folder recursively. So let me also give a with column of file name so that we can understand that as well. So we are getting the expected output. By this way, by this approach, we will be able to read all the files under the folder recursively. But one disadvantage with the second method of recursive file lookup is if you enable it as true, you should be aware like the input folder that you have is not partitioned by, like it is not partition specific. If you have a partition specific input file, then it will throw an exception and this method will not work. So that alone you have to keep in mind. Apart from that, this method will serves you better to read all the files recursively. Hope you guys understood this concept better. Please do try this in your own machine and let me know if you face any issues. I am happy to help you guys. Thanks for watching guys. Please do subscribe to my channel and also give a thumbs up signal if you really like my content. Thank you.